In the previous video, we made the master robot which has 8 potentiometers. We printed all of the parts, assembled, successfully tested. The robot sends its angle value of the wireless signal through HC12 module. In this video, we are going to make this slave robot which parts are 3D printed. The robot has 11 motors including the head motor and 2 motors for leg, but in this episode, we only use 8 motors. Since we already made most of them, all we have to do is just printing parts and assemble them together. Let's get started. I designed all of the 3D files and uploaded them on Thingiverse. In the below description, there is an address I left. Download the files and print them one by one. These white parts are for making a group of 2 motors. We are going to make 8 modules. They look all same, but they are not. 4 parts are mirrored against the others. They are used depending on the location of each joint. If you follow this video carefully, you can easily make it. The parts we are looking at are for the body. We are going to make shoulder frames. When inserting the motor into the frame, the most important thing is to insert it at the midpoint. As you can see, I turned it to the left and right, tested and plugged it at around middle. We don't need to be perfect because we can adjust them to some extent later. Usually, such a small motor has only one axis rotation. In order to build a humanoid robot, it must be mechanically supported on both sides of the motor. Otherwise, it cannot stand its weight. The white parts are for supporting the other side by using a bolt. Now, we are going to make elbows. In this way, I found the middle of the motor. The horn is slightly long, so I cut the end. Please wear safety glasses when cutting using a nipper. When fixing the opposite side of the motor drive shaft, do not turn it all the way, just fix slightly. Normally, bearings are supposed to be here, but this kind of small size robot is enough with this technique. The elbow motors also need modification. Attach the cover. We need 2 motors modified. Assemble 2 elbows. The left arm and right arm are different. Please check the video carefully. These are hands. Hand frame may be changed later. The look of the robot can be changed depending on the shape of the hand. Assemble all of the arms. Be sure to connect the frame on the midpoint of the motor. First, assemble the head motor in the center. We are not going to operate the head motor at this moment, but we need to assemble it for the following episode. Assemble the right and left arm on the top frame where the head motor is assembled. Assemble the bottom frame and front frame as well. I'm going to put the head. Head frame design may be changed later. Considering the functional aspect of the robot, the head has no function. After long consideration, I finally decided to put an extra motor for the head, because this motor is not for functional but for emotional. I'm going to make a frame to temporarily hold the body. I also add Pringles again. Use a hot melt glue to connect the lid to the body. Make a hole on the lid. The cable will pass through the hole. Connect the cables to the board one by one, like picture and video. If you don't understand this board, please refer to previous episode. The USB cable and power cable also pass through the hole and connect it to the board. Finish the board with an isolation tape. As I mentioned in the previous episode, the Pringles bottom is made of aluminum. I cut the plastic and put it into the bin to prevent the circuit. Almost done. Turn on the power and try the test. In order to adjust the angle, reassemble the potentiometers of the master robot. Congratulations! We made it. We made it. Now, we can create a remotely controllable robot with 8 motors. Let's recall from the beginning. We made one servo move with one potentiometer. We made 8 servos move with 8 potentiometers. We also remotely controlled them. We made a master robot and slave robot. I think we are pretty cool. In the next episode, we will make leg for the robot. If you have any question, feel free to let me know in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Bye.